Blood cell structure. Blasts are unique among the eukaryotes, organisms whose cells have membrane-enclosed nuclei and organelles, because they can manufacture their own food. Chlorophyll, which gives plants their green color, enables them to use sunlight to convert water and carbon dioxide into sugars and carbohydrates. Chemicals, the cell uses for fuel. Anatomy of the plant cell. Like the fungi, another kingdom of eukaryotes, plant cells have retained the protective cell wall structure of their prokaryotic ancestor. The basic plant cell shares a similar construction motif to the typical eukaryote cell, but does not have centrioles, lysosomes, intermediate filaments, cilia, or flagella, as does the animal cell. Plant cells do, however, have a number of specialized structures, including a rigid cell wall, central vacuole, plasmomestata, and chloroplast, although plants and their typical cells are non-motile. Some species produce gametes that do exhibit flagella and are, therefore, able to move out. A plant cell refers to any cell of a plant. It's the structural and functional unit of plants. Plant cells are presumed to have evolved from the early green algae and probably first occurred in the early Paleozoic era, more than 500 million years ago. What's in plant cell? Plant cells have a nucleus, cell membrane, cytoplasm, and mitochondria too, but they also contain the following structures. Cell wall, a hard layer outside the cell membrane, containing cellulose to provide strength to the plant.
Plants exhibit life cycle that involves alternating generations of diploid forms which contain paired chromosome set, nuclei and haploid form, which only possess a single set. Generally, these two forms of a plant are very similar in appearance. In higher plants, the diploid generation, the member of which are known as sporophytes generation. In higher phytes, however, the gametophyte form is a dominant and psychologically necessary to the sporophyte form. Animals are required to consume protein in order to obtain nitrogen. But plants are able to utilize inorganic forms of element and therefore do not need an outside source of protein. Plants do, however, usually require significant amount of water, which is needed for the photosynthetic process. To maintain cell structure and facilitate growth, and as a means of bringing nutrients to plant cells. The amount of nutrient needed by plant species varies significantly, but 9 elements are generally considered to be necessary in a relatively large amount. Third microelements, these nutrients include calcium, carbon, hydrogen, magnesium, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, potassium, and sulfur. 7 elements which are required by plant in smaller quantities have also been identified: boron, chlorine, copper, iron, manganese, molybdenum, and zinc.
Thought to have evolved from the green algae, plants have been around since the early Paleozoic era, more than 500 million years ago. The earliest fossil evidence of land plant dates to the Ordovician period, or 505 to 438 million years ago. By the Carboniferous period, about 355 million years ago, most of the earth was covered by forests of primitive vascular plants such as lycopods, horse-scale trees, and gymnosperms, or pine trees, and ginkgos. Angiosperms, the flowering plants, didn't develop until the end of the Cretaceous period, about 65 million years ago, just as the dinosaurs became extinct. Cell wall. Like their prokaryotic ancestors, plant cells have a rigid wall surrounding the plasma membrane. It is a far more complex structure, however, and serves a variety of functions, from protecting the cells to regulating the life cycle of the plant organism. Chloroplasts. The most important characteristics of the plants is their ability to photosynthesize, in effect to make their own food by converting light energy into chemical energy. The process is carried out in specialized organelles called chloroplasts. Endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum is a network of sacs that manufactures, processes, and transports chemical compounds for use inside and outside of the cell. It is connected to the double-layered nuclear envelope, providing a pipeline between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. In plants, the endoplasmic reticulum also connects between
Golgi apparatus. The Golgi apparatus is the distribution and shipping department for the cell's chemical products. It modifies protein and fats built in the endoplasmic reticulum and prepares them for export as outside of the cell. Microfilaments. Microfilaments are solid rods made of the globular proteins called actin. These filaments are primary, structural in function, and are an important component of the cytoskeleton. Microtubules. These straight hollow cylinders are found throughout the cytoplasm of all eukaryotic cells and carry out a variety of functions ranging from transport to structural support. Mitochondria. Mitochondria are oblong-shaped organelles found in the cytoplasm of all eukaryotic cells. In plant cells, they break down carbohydrate and sugar molecules to provide energy, particularly when light isn't available for the chloroplast to produce energy. Nucleus. The nucleus is a highly specialized organelle that serves as the information processing and administrative center of the cells. This organelle has two major functions. It stores the cell's hereditary material, or DNA, and it coordinates the cell's activities, which include growth, intermediary, metabolism, protein synthesis, and reproduction or cell division.
Peroxisomes. Microbodies are a diverse group of organelles that are found in the cytoplasm, roughly spherical and bound by a single membrane. There are several types of microbodies, but peroxisomes are the most common. Plasmodesmata. Plasmodesmata are small tubes that connect plant cells to each other, providing living bridges between cells. Plasma membrane. All living cells have a plasma membrane that encloses their contents. In prokaryotes and plants, the membrane in the inner layer of protection surrounded by a rigid cell wall. These membranes also regulate the passage of molecules in and out of the cell. Ribosomes. All living cells contain ribosomes, tiny organelles composed of approximately 60% RNA and 40% protein. In eukaryotes, ribosomes are made of 4 strands of RNA. In prokaryotes, they consist of 3 strands of RNA. Vacuole. Each plant cell has a large single vacuole that stores compounds, helps plant growth, and plays an important structural role for the plant. Leaf tissue organization. The plant body is divided into several organs, roots, stems, and leaves. The leaves are primary photosynthetic organs of plants, serving as key sites where energy from light is converted into chemical energy. Similar to the other organs of a plant, a leaf is comprised of 3 basic tissue systems, including the dermal, vascular, and ground tissue systems. These 3 motifs are continuous throughout an entire plant, but their properties vary significantly based upon the organ type in which they are located. All 3 tissue systems are discussed in this section.
Plants can be broadly categorized into 2, vascular and non-vascular plants.
And the vascular plants are more advanced compared to the non-vascular because they have these specialized tissues called xylem and phloem. And take note that xylem is responsible for the conduction of water, while phloem is responsible for the conduction of food. Consequently, they also possess roots, stems, and leaves, representing a higher form of organization that is characteristically absent in lacking vascular tissues. The non-vascular plants are the members of the division Bryophyta, are usually no more than an inch or two in height, because they do not have adequate support, which is provided by vascular plants. These vascular tissues allows plants to grow bigger, also more dependent on the environment that surrounds them, maintain the appropriate amount of moisture, and therefore tend to inhabit damp or in shady areas. An example of a non-vascular plant that is mostly seen in our environment are moss or lumut. Did you know that it is estimated that there are at least 260,000 species of plants in the world today? They range in sizes and complexity of small, non-vascular mosses to giant sequoia or sequoia trees, the largest living organism, growing as tall as 330 feet or 110 meters. Only a tiny percentage of those species are directly used by people for food, shelter, fiber, or medicine. Nonetheless, plants are the basis for the Earth's ecosystem, coming from food to food web, and without them, complex animal life forms such as us humans could never have evolved. Indeed, all living organisms are dependent either directly or indirectly on the energy produced by photosynthesis and the byproduct of this process. Oxygen, on the other hand, is essential to animals. Plants also reduce the amount of carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere, hinder soil erosion, and influence water levels and quality. I hope you learned a lot in this short video lesson about the plant cell. And I hope that you're already familiarized by its types, to its parts, and to its importance in our ecosystem. That's all for now, and I hope to see you guys in our next video presentation. Thank you for watching!